Okay, let's move on. So here is another way of improving the features of a bar chart. So here we have four activities. You can see four activities. You have duration, and I'm actually specifying the cost. Okay, so you can see there is a cost. There's a total cost associated with each of these activities. Now, as we go here, we can see that the activities now have been put in a bar chart in the following form. So what we saw earlier, that a cost curve can be plotted, right? So how would I now go about plotting a cost curve? So here is some of the data. Yes, yes. So that is one. I have to assume that my cost per day will be uniform. So if I assume that, it will be 3000 divided by 3. So it will be 1000 per day here, 2000 per day here, 1000 per day here. Okay. And I will be, yeah, it will be a fraction in the other one. And we will now distribute it. So you will find that, so here it is 111, okay, 1000. Okay, here 222, here 111, 0.4, 0.4, 0.4. And when you sum it up totally, what you get is a cost for that day. Okay, I can plot this in the form of a histogram. So I have a bar chart for how much money am I expecting to spend on each day. So I might have to mobilize. So let's say this is a small construction project, and this cost I'm talking about might be something like wage for daily labor. I might have to bring this much money to me to the site each day. It helps me to plan my amount of money I have to bring. Okay, very simple example. Now the same values can be represented as a cumulative cost. So basically all we are doing is in the first day that's 1, second day it's 3 plus 1 that's 4, then okay add 7, add plus 4 plus 3 is 7, and it goes on. So this is how my money is flowing through the project, or at least for that component, over time. And this is a rough graph. Okay, we can do this in Excel, but this is a rough graph of how the cash flows for that component over time for each of the days. Now the same thing can be done in Excel or I have a demo in Excel which I will show later, but this is just to give you an idea that bar chart is more than simply bars which do continuous bars with related to activities. It can actually represent resources, it can represent costs, it can represent a lot, it depends on the power which you want to give it and the kind of information you want to represent on the bar chart. And again, I urge you to look at the writings of Gantt, because that's what's available to us, and you will see that he actually used it for all these purposes. Okay, now we're coming to, probably I should ask this from you. What do you think are the advantages of the bar chart? What do you think are the disadvantages of the bar chart? Yeah, so that's a disadvantage. That is, when I have a representation like this, I don't know, the sequencing is what the planner put into the bar chart. As a third person, I cannot find relationships. What resources are shared could be specified, but not that simply. Yes. So that is another one.
One thing is that if the progress can be shown. Hmm. So in that, if the project is got delayed some 3 months. Now the project was to be finished by one such activity is finished by November, but it's now in February. So the progress, we can't show that progress actually.
You mean the delay?
Yeah, the delay. If the project is going on its schedule, so the February at this point it will show, okay, today is 5th February and the project is showing this progress.
Right.
But if it was delayed, so at February 5th we can't progress it. We have to show it in the November calendar only.
Right. I'm not sure I fully understand your question or the point you're making well, but you will see there are some very sophisticated ways you can show delays and projected finish. We'll come to that. Okay. So please write this down. I mean, in terms of showing where is it currently, and what is the projected finish can be actually shown. Can be shown. Okay. It just depends on your notation. And obviously that's not something that we can calculate manually very easily and do it, but there are notations to show that in a bar chart.
One slide was there actually,
I go back here?
Yeah, in this one. So if the project XYZ
right.
is now in January, July.
Right.
So if say the development is delayed by March, so it wouldn't be showing.
You mean it cannot show historical?
Historical.
Okay. If you're talking about, yes, I can't show the delays that were happened historically. In this bar, no. But if I have an earlier bar chart of that period, it will show what was the delay at that time. So you're right. I cannot show my everything that happened on my project. So actually, if I have caught up by July, then I will not be able to see what the status was in March in today's bar chart, but I can go to March's bar chart and see the issue.
If the development is delayed, so
no, let's say project XYZ.
Okay.
Right now, and let's say it was delayed. So when I was in April, there was some delay. So I would not have been in a good situation, right? If I'm taking July's date, I cannot find out that situation today. That is. But I take back April's bar chart and I will know my situation at that time.
Or I can use different color coding.
I can use, but then it becomes, so again, we'll have to see. Bar charts can be, so basically through color coding, through symbols, through this, we can make a bar chart mean a lot. But again, if the bar chart is nice because it's simple enough to visualize, but if we make it too complicated, then we lose the purpose of the bar chart. Okay.
It's difficult to right. use the bar chart.
Right. So if there are a lot of activities, projects have 1,000, 1,500 very easily. Okay, unless I start subnetting it and putting it, I cannot use just a bar chart for planning it. I need some other methodology, which then I get parts of the project in the form of a bar chart. Other advantages or disadvantages. Okay, so if we go through the list, it's certainly an intuitive representation. Okay, and we all can relate to what should be happening at what time without too much of training or reading. We should be able to do that. It communicates to any level of an organization. So typically a bar chart you'll find is used at the field execution level. They'll say, oh, this much work should be done in a week, and it is also used to present results to top management. Again, you're making a management presentation easy to represent. I don't want to show complicated networks or things like that. So very, very good communication tool. Okay, it is excellent representation for final planning and monitoring information, because you can actually summarize all that quite well in a bar chart. Okay, ideal for projects that are simple and sequential. Simple sequential activities, yes, then a bar chart. Now, problems, dependencies cannot be represented. We discussed that. Limitations in number of activities, we discussed that. It cannot be used as an analytical tool. That is, all of the information that represented the bar chart, the way we are doing it now, meaning, yeah, we process the information and we put it in. Okay, there is no inbuilt analytics in the bar chart. And when we move to more sophisticated techniques, you will see there is a lot more analytics in the technique. Okay, and again, when you have large complex projects with a lot of interdependence, a lot of activities, a lot of sub activities, that again, very much related to limitation in number of activities and in logic, but it becomes unwieldy and we will not be able to use it. Okay, so we have done these exercises from the planning point of view, and we have also discussed these from the control point of view a little bit, but we would probably as we go more into the course, we will take up examples which are from the construction domain. Okay, there are any further questions or comments? Okay, thank you.